Hi, I'm Emil, the Practical Engineer, and today I'm making this drill-powered metal hacksaw. To power the saw with my drill, I need to convert rotary motion into linear motion. And I'm doing that by making an axle that fits onto my drill, that has a point off-center that moves like this. And when you connect an arm to it, the saw will go with it like that. I'll show you later. Start with the axle. These plates are going to be the frame of the whole mechanism. So the axle is going to be in here and the hinge for the saw arm is going to be in here as well. I've screwed them together so when I drill these holes, I know they're all similar in both plates. So the first thing I want to do is to connect this to the base. Then I can make the big arm for the saw, where it's mounted on, and the drive arm for the saw. So I have the part for the saw arm made. There's this tube, this is going to be the saw arm itself. And then I have this bearing that I printed that will fit over here, which will hold the saw like this. And then it will move forward and backward to saw. So now I know this fits, I'm gonna take it apart shortly so I can paint the base of it, make it look a bit nicer. So now I have this all mounted. I need to make the arm that connects the driving arm to the saw. And I'm gonna make that from plywood. I also need to make a bushing for over here where it can connect to. As you can see, it's almost done. Only thing I need to do left is to mount the clamp for it. And I have only one clamp, so I want it to be removable. I printed these small holders that fit in here. And I think that if I screw it really tight, I can place it on, it will stay in place. And when I'm not using it here, I can take it off. It's not super fast, but it's faster than I can do it by hand, so that's a win. And it's also a lot easier, so I really like it. Let's try some other materials. I'm really happy with how it turned out. It cuts faster than I can do by hand, and also it cuts really straight. So if you're happy with this video as well, let me know in the comments. Hit that subscribe button before you leave, and don't forget, dare to experiment and have fun creating. See you in the next video.